Welcome back to Money Exchange. Markets have been anticipating more stimulus from the European Central Bank for months now, and December was earmarked as the likely month. The euro has been falling sharply since mid-October, that is, until last night, when it shot back higher by as much as 4% against the US dollar. Joining us from London is senior currency dealer and economist at Go Markets, Jay Morgie. Hi, Jay. Great to see you again, and thanks very much for your time.
Good morning. Nice to see you too.
Now, before we go any further, let me have a chat with you about this euro rally overnight. Has this been overdone? Is this something that the market has got into a frizzle about, or whatever you like to call it, in terms of the reaction on the euro has certainly been, in my view anyway, overstated a little bit. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, would you believe it? Interesting enough, we're now in a euro strength position. Obviously, ECB met yesterday. We were expecting some kind of stronger action from them. There was a little bit of action. They cut the deposit facility rate down from -0.2 to -0.3, as expected, to kind of get the banks stimulating more lending. But other than that, not a lot more. There was all this talk about a further expansion. They have extended it, back to March 2017, but they certainly haven't added more to it. There's no doubt the market priced something or some more action in. We haven't seen that. And here we are, euro strength. We know that the ECB were talking about additional measures, and Nowotny is famous for talking about it. And it looks like they might step away from a strong expansionary policy and start to add other stimulus. So a strong euro, no one expected it, but here it is.
So we're up about 4% in the last 24 hours. We've got the US job numbers coming today in the US, expecting over 200,000 jobs for the month of November. Does that have the potential to reverse that euro strength and send it back lower? Because I anticipate if we get a good jobs number, the market's going to be focused on that US rate rise on December the 18th.
That's exactly where it's going to be. We know that Janet Yellen's talked about her excitement or her keenness to put a rate rise in finally. There's been two factors to that. The first part is obviously participation on the labor market. Now with a good or a fairly positive job number, she believes that there might be enough merit to start to raise rates in a couple of weeks' time. The other side is the inflationary pressure, which she says inflation should come back to the 2% expectation. So absolutely, a good jobs figure, that could be the trigger that the Fed's been waiting on.
So, Jay, do you think with respect to the stimulus that Draghi and the ECB has injected into the European economy so far, has it been successful? Because I'm reading from the statement overnight that it's clear that the ECB at this point think they're doing enough, even though inflation still remains very low.
It's a difficult situation. I think with all economic policy, it's much easier to wait it out a little bit, to feel the market out, to feel the economy out, and take action when needed. The risk is if you do too much too soon, you run out of options. And then when you start doing too much, then you have an economy that's out of control on all aspects. So we know that the ECB can take the action we need them to take. I think that they were sensible to some respects to perhaps ride it out. There's a little bit of action that's going to come out of other economies, which will obviously have a knock-on effect in the eurozone. So there is an element of if they hold out, there is more in the tank, as it were, and there is more they can do in the coming months.
I've been shorting the euro now with our clients for a number of months, and we've enjoyed that ride down since sort of around mid-October. With that recent rally up in the last 24 hours, what should I expect, and I'm asking you as an economist, what should I expect and what do I need to see for the euro to turn on its heels and head back lower again? Because I'm keen to short it again, and I think it is going to be lower in the next 6 to 9 months, but I'm keen to hear your thoughts as well.
Well, it's two sides. If you look at the euro on a whole, if the economy doesn't prosper, if they don't get out of the situation they're in, then we will start to see more action out of central bank, and that's critical to see a weaker euro. That's certainly what we expected yesterday, and certainly I don't think the long-term expectation has changed, or the medium-term certainly hasn't. It's just a matter of riding out this, can I say, somewhat delay in policy movement. And then you've got to look around the economy. Potentially there is a situation with Britain in the eurozone. There is a situation with the central bank in the US, obviously, with rate rises. Our own bank here could well engage in rate rises. So there is a possibility that this is just a short-term maneuver. So you're looking for action or certainly movement from policy from other nations as well.
I'm assuming that the ECB, Jay, doesn't want a higher euro. I mean, surely a lower euro's got to be good for the broader Europe at this point in time. And even though that they would have known that the euro was going to spike back higher, I'm sure that the ECB doesn't want a higher euro over the coming 6 to 12 months. They prefer to have it lower, wouldn't they?
Absolutely. I think a lower euro is going to help them to start to export more. It's going to start to help them to start to generate the economy a little bit better. A strong euro is definitely not going to help them at all.
We saw European stocks fall very sharply overnight. We've been talking about here on the program stimulus from the ECB going to be good for European equity markets. Is this pullback for those traders watching the program that are investing in European stocks, expecting more stimulus from Europe, is this pullback on stock markets a good opportunity to buy? I mean, is this a good level to get back and buy those European stock indexes?
Well, I think what you've got to look at is why we haven't seen this continued rise in the equity markets in Europe. When we talk about quantitative easing, we expect it to come into various forms. At the moment, Europe is primarily focused in putting it in local and government debt, so bonds coming out of those areas or those particular assets. What we'd like to hear is them talking about purchasing more in the asset program overall. If that happens, so the quantitative easing extended to purchasing, you know, asset-backed securities or things like that, then there's certainly going to be a rally in the equity markets.
All right, Jay, let's go over to the pound. What are your thoughts on the pound leading into the end of the year and into next year? Obviously, the pound's had a nice rally for the last couple of years. We talked on the program a few weeks ago about perhaps it's running out of legs. Are you still of that opinion?
It's starting to look a little bit wary at the moment. We've been on the back of this ride of interest rate hikes for quite some time. We haven't seen it yet. I don't want to say talk is kind of simmering down, but it's certainly not as fiery as we probably wanted it to be coming into the back end of this year. The question really is when we're going to see this rate hike. That's the fundamental driving principle of the value of sterling at the moment. So has it run out of legs? Not yet, but is it going to? It's looking like it's a little bit weaker there.
All right, well, our anticipation is perhaps the euro to drift back lower, the pound to move a little bit higher. Jay, thanks for getting up early this morning and joining us here on Money Exchange. Much appreciated.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
Now, before we go to a short break, I want to remind you all at home that I've just released an updated version of my best-selling book, The 7-Minute Workday. And for a limited time, I'm giving away some free copies to Money Exchange viewers. So if you're one of the millions of people who hate working, jump onto moneyexchangetv.com. And if you're quick, you can download a free copy of my book right now. That's The 7-Minute Workday. All you need to do is jump onto moneyexchange.com, moneyexchangetv.com. Coming up shortly, we'll speak to a man who will tell us about the best deals when it comes to travel cards and exchange rates. Don't go away, more in a moment.